Welcome guys in this WooCommerce tutorial series. My name is Rana and in this WooCommerce tutorial, I'll show you how you can create or add a simple and variable products in your e-commerce website with WooCommerce plugin. If you haven't checked out my other WooCommerce tutorial, you can go to the description box of this video and watch other WooCommerce tutorial. Before you watch this video, make sure you watch my basic setup of WooCommerce. Once you finish with your basic setup of WooCommerce plugin, then you can start adding simple and variable products or other kind of products on your e-commerce website with WooCommerce plugin. And of course, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please consider subscribing because I drop a new video every week on this channel. And don't forget to press that bell icon. With that, whenever I upload a new video on this channel, you will get notified. And don't forget to hit the like button as well. That would be appreciated, guys. So enough talking, let's get started. Alright guys, so first of all, we will look at how to add a simple product on your e-commerce website. So this is my demo website. We are going to add a simple product. Let's open this dummy product, black hoodie. So this is our simple product. This is the title, pricing, and short description, full description, and so on and so forth. Let me show you how you can add this type of simple product. Let's go to the dashboard. Make sure you have installed WooCommerce. Once you have it, hover your mouse over products, click on add new. So here, let's type the product name. So I'm gonna type black hoodie, new. Below that, we are going to add full description. So this would be your full description, okay? Copy the text, just add full description, something like that. So I have added a full description. This is a dummy text. Below that, we have the product data. Here, you have to choose simple product. Right next to this, we have virtual or downloadable. We will look at these options later on. Right now, this is a simple product. So we're gonna leave it as it is. So under the general option, we have a regular price. Let's type your regular price, 500 rupee. Okay, here you can type in the sale price if you want. Let's say 350 would be the sale price. You can schedule your sale. Let's say this sale will occur from this date to that date. Let's say October 1st to November 30. Okay, there would be sale between these days. If you want to schedule your sale, then you can go ahead, schedule it. Otherwise, you can cancel it. Okay, below that, we have text status. This would be taxable or non-taxable or shipping only. Let's go with taxable. Text class, standard text class, due date, zero date. This depends on your country. I'm from India. In India, we deal with GST, but right now I haven't created any text class, but you can check out the text class video separately by going to the description box of this video. Once you created your text class, you can select from here. Okay. Next, we have the inventory. Here you can type your SKU number. If you have SKU number, you can type in over here. Otherwise, you can leave it blank. Next, we have manage stock. You can enable this option on any specific product. Below that, we have the stock quantity. If you type something like 10 or 5 maybe, basically you are telling your visitor or your customer that only 10 quantity left. They should make it hurry to buy it. Otherwise, that would be gone. Okay, basically you are creating a scary environment on your e-commerce website. Next, we have the allow back orders. If you go with do not allow, that means you are not allowing your customer to buy this product when this product goes out of stock or does not have the quantity left. If you go with allow, that means you are simply allowing your customer to place an order whenever if there is no quantity left, okay? Or you can allow but notify the customer. That means you are simply notify the customer whenever you have more quantity in your stock. Okay, below that we have low stock threshold. You can type in something like 2 maybe. If the quantity reach at this number, you will get notified. You can hover your mouse over here and you can read the note. Below that we have sold individually. If you enable this option, that means your customer only able to buy this product on single order. So I don't really like this option. Next we have shipping tab. First, we have to type in the product weight. So right now I have changed my weight unit into grams because I'm selling clothes on my e-commerce website. If you have heavy products like TV or furniture or something like that, then you should go with kilograms. So here I'm gonna type something like this product weight would be 200 grams. And next we have the dimension, centimeter, 35, width 25, or height 10, whatever number you want. This is just for demonstration purposes. I've typed in over here, or you can leave it blank if you don't know about the product dimension. Okay, so next we have shipping class. If you want to add this product under any shipping class, you can add it. Right now I'm not going to add this product under any shipping class. If you want to learn more about shipping classes, you can check out my advanced shipping tutorial of WooCommerce. You can find that video link below of this video, or you can click over here and check out that video for advanced shipping tutorial. Anyways, so I'm not going to add any shipping class. Next we have linked products. First we have upsell and cross sell. If you want to show related products on the product page, something like that, what you can do, you can type the product name, maybe type something like hoodie, blue hoodie, or you can add more, green hoodie. That means you are showing your customer more items on the product page so that they can add those items as well when they're trying to buy this product. Okay, that is very useful option. Cross sale, basically you are showing more products to your customer when they do checkout. Why would you confuse your customer when they're on checkout page? So I don't really recommend you to add cross sell. Okay, so I'm gonna leave it blank. If you still want to add it, you can add products on the checkout page as well. In the same way, you can type something like blue hoodie or black hoodie or blue t-shirts, whatever product you want to add on the checkout page for your customer, you can add it over here. But I don't recommend you to do it. Okay, you can remove it if you want. Anyways, let's go to the attributes. We are not dealing with attributes right now because we are creating simple product. Let's go ahead, look at the advanced tab. Here you can type the purchase note, something like great sale. Below that we have menu order. You can type whatever number you want for your menu order. I don't really like it because I always customize my order with categories. Enable reviews. Make sure you enable reviews on your product page. Very important. Reviews will tell your new customer that this product is great because many people are buying this product. Obviously, you know, reviews are very important. Next we have the cart flow. This is my theme option, so we are not going to cover it. Below that we have get more options tab. You can add different types of extension in your WooCommerce plugin. You can browse more extensions by clicking over here. So these are the extensions that you can use in your WooCommerce plugin. Okay, anyways, below that we have the short description. Let's copy the short description from here, paste in. Let's look at the right section. Right side we have the product category. Let's go ahead add this product under a category. Let's go ahead create a new category by clicking on add new category. I'm gonna type in something like hoodies and click on add new category. So I've added this product under this hoodies category. By creating these categories, you're simply allowing your customer to navigate on your website easily. If they're looking for hoodies on your website, they can go to the hoodies category and they can buy any hoodie from there. Right below we have the product tags. You can type something like hoodies, black hoodie. You can type whatever you want, right? By adding the product tags, people can navigate through your website easily with the help of these tags. Okay, scroll down. Below we have extra settings, so we are not looking at this section right now because this is a specific theme setting. Okay, below that we have product image. Let's set the product image. This is a black hoodie. Let's go ahead select black hoodie from there. Click on set product image. Scroll down, we have product gallery. Let's add product gallery images. In this product gallery images, you have to add different images of the same product from different angle. Okay, if you have black hoodie, you have to click different images from different angle, then you have to select them. So I don't have more images of this product from different angle, so I'm gonna select the same image. Okay, we are done here. Scroll up and click on publish. Okay, let's go ahead look at our product. Alright guys, so as you can see, we have created this black hoodie new product. This is our regular price. This is a sale price. This is a short description. And below that we have availability, 10 in stock. That means we have 10 stock left of this product. And we have the category. We have hoodies. We have product tags over here. And below that we have gallery images. We have added only one image. And below that you can see we have a long tail description over here. Okay. If you go to the additional information, you can see we have weight 200 grams, dimensions we have set this number, and you also see this upsell right here, blue hoodie and green hoodie, right? And we also have reviews. People can start typing their reviews over here. That is very useful. Okay. If you go to this dummy product, you can see in the additional information, there is only weight is right there. We don't have dimension over here, but we added the dimension in our this simple product, right? Alright guys, so this is how you can create a simple product on your e-commerce website with WooCommerce plugin. Okay, now let's look at how to add or create a variable products on your e-commerce website with WooCommerce plugin. First of all, let's come back to the dashboard of your WordPress site and hover your mouse over products. Click on add new. First, let's type the product name, hoodie black and blue. And below that, you have to type in the full description. And then let's add this product under this hoodie category. Below that, let's type in the tags, black hoodie, blue hoodie, something like that. And in the left side, we have product data. This time we will select variable products. In the journal tabs, we have the text status. This is would be a taxable or non-taxable. Let's go with taxable, standard text class. And of course, you can add your own text class according to your country. So right now I haven't created any text class. Next we have inventory. You can enable inventory if you want. You can type in the SKU number. It's all up to you. Next you have shipping. Let's go ahead, type the weight of the product. This would be 200 grams. And dimension, you can type the dimension over here. You can add a shipping class if you want. We're not going to add this product under any shipping class. Okay, let's go with linked product. We have upsell or cross sale. You can add upsell for this product. Let's type hoodie, green hoodie, black hoodie, new, whatever products you want to add, you can type in over here. Below we have cross sale. I don't really like the cross sale, like I mentioned earlier. I'm not gonna add the cross sales. Next we have attributes and we have variations. Okay, first we have to create an attribute. To do it, let's come over here and select custom product attribute. We have only this option. Let's go ahead, click on add. Let's go ahead, create a color attribute, and under the value you have to type in the colors, how many colors you have for this product. Let's say we have red color, and then hold down alt key and then press 1, 2, 4 quickly. And you can add this symbol. And next I'm gonna add black. Let's go ahead, add this symbol once again. This time I'm gonna type green. So we have added red, green and blue. Next, click on this use for variations and then click on save attribute. So you can see we have created this one attribute. Let's go ahead, add more attributes by clicking over here. This time I'm gonna type size, and here let's type small and type this symbol and type medium and large. And check this option, use for variations, and then click on save attribute. So now we have created two types of attribute, color and size. Let's go to the variation, click on this drop down button and select create variations for all attributes and click go, and then click OK. Now we have added 9 variations, click OK. So you can see we have 9 variations. We have 3 red color with 3 sizes. We have 3 black color with 3 sizes, small, medium, large. In the same way, we have green with 3 sizes. Okay. So next thing you have to do is you have to expand each of them one by one. And then we have to add the product images, product price, so on and so forth. Let me show you what I mean by that. Let's expand red small. First, we have to select the image. This is a red small. Okay. Let's choose this red hoodie and then click on set variation image. You can type in the SKU number if you have. You can leave it blank if you don't have. Here you have to type in the regular price. Regular price would be 500. Sale price would be 350. You can schedule it if you want. So I'm gonna leave it as it is. Next, you have to type in the weight. Let's say this would be 200 grams. Dimension, 350, 25, whatever your number you want. Next, you can add a shipping class. So I'm not going to add it. You can add text class if you want. I haven't created any text class yet. You can add standard text class if you want, or you can add same as parents. Okay, below that you can add a description for this particular attribute. Once you do it, do the same with all the attributes. Okay, once you do it, click on save changes. And next we have advanced tab. You can type in the purchase note if you want. I'm gonna type in something like great sale. Next, I'm gonna leave it as it is. Below that we have the short description. Let's copy the short description from this product. Okay, right side we have product image. Let's go ahead, select the product image. Let's go with red, set the product image. Below that we have the product gallery images. I'm gonna select multiple images. By holding down Control, add images to the gallery, scroll up, let's go to the variations, and here we have the default form value. Here you can select a default value. Whenever someone going to open this product, what kind of color should be shown first? Let's go with red, let's go with medium. This would be default value. Now scroll up, we are all done. Click on publish. Let's view the product by clicking over here. Alright guys, so we have created this product. We have the title, regular price, sale price, we have short description, and we have the variation. We can go with black, we can go with green, we can select the size, we can select the quantity. You can see we don't added the SKU number. We have this category, we have this tags. Below that we have the product gallery images, we have long tail description, we have additional information, weight, dimension, color, size, and we have reviews tab as well. So you can see we added the upsell product as well on this product. So this is how you can add or create a variable products in your e-commerce website with WooCommerce plugin. So that's the end of this video. I hope you enjoy the video. If you learned something from today's video, don't forget to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more videos just like this one. And make sure guys check out my other product creation video with WooCommerce plugin. You can find that video link in the description box of this video and as well as in the end screen card of this video. So that being said, goodbye, and I'll see you in the next video.